Hi everyone. So today we go through the supplier applet. So basically supplier applet is the master data for the supplier. So means whatever information about your supplier, then you will be keying into this applet. Okay. So for this supplier applet, so we got few module here. First one is the supplier. So this one will show all the list of your supplier and all the information of your supplier. The second one is the category. So this one is your to set the category, then you can link this category to your supplier. And then third one is the file import. So this one, if let's say you want to upload the supplier, then you can use this function. And then these two is the upload for the credit term and credit limit. Okay. So first thing first, let's go through the supplier creation. Okay. So basically for the view, for the listing, you will see there is the list of the current supplier in the listing. Okay. So if let's say you want to filter, then you can go to the advanced search and filter by the keyword or by the entity type or by the status and also by the category. Okay. So example, if let's say I filter by corporate, then it will show the list of the corporate. Okay. So if let's say you want to edit, then you can go to the supplier, and then you can edit whatever information that you want to be edited. Okay. So if let's say you see here, we got two. This one is the toggle. So if let's say you want to see one full screen, then you just click on it, then you will see one full page of your supplier. Okay. So if let's say you want to see two page, then you just click back to two page. Okay. So now I go back to how to create the supplier. Okay, so to create a supplier, you just need to click on the plus button. Okay, so when I click on the plus button, then the system will ask if let's say you want to have your own supplier code, then you can key in your supplier code. Or if let's say you want the system to use the running number for the supplier from the system, then you can just list empty and then you just key in your supplier name. So for example, if I put supplier name as Ledger, and then entity type, if let's say your supplier is also a customer, then you can also select the customer or it's an employee or merchant. Okay, so for example, this one I just put a supplier as a supplier itself, and then type, is it a individual supplier or corporate supplier? Okay. And then identity type, if let's say you want to put the IC, you want to put, if let's say it is an individual supplier, then you can put IC or BRN. So this is optional. And then phone number, email also optional. Okay. So if let's say your supplier is non-trade supplier, then you can change the default GR code to AP others. By default, system will put to AP trade. If let's say it is a non-trade supplier, then you can put AP others. Okay. So if let's say I don't put any supplier code and then I just click on the create, system will will generate the running number for the supplier. Okay. But I also able to edit to use my own running number as well. Okay. So after I already create, the system will go to the edit page. So in the edit page, you can see what is your supplier name, what is the supplier code. Okay. So if let's say you want to edit an identity type, then you can just go to add and then I put description of your supplier, phone number, email, all this one you can edit from here lah. If let's say you want to set a default purchase return pricing option, also you can set it here. Okay. So the next step is the e-invoice. So whatever information that you already key in under the main that required for the e-invoice, system will auto-populate it. Okay. So that the supplier name is coming from the main detail. Okay. So for this e-invoice, you only required to key in if let's say you want to issue the self-bill invoice. Okay. Because the customer is the one that you issue invoice. So for the supplier, if let's say you are not issuing any invoice, then it's not required for you to fill up this tab. Okay. So if let's say you need to key in the self-bill invoice for that supplier, you can go to the e-invoice self-bill here to set as true. So whenever there is any sales in any purchase invoice created under this supplier, system will auto detect it as a self-bill purchase invoice. Okay, so that is the difference. So this one you need to set the supplier ID type. I put BRN and I put and then supplier team. So if let's say you want to verify, then you just click. So it will show is it a verified or not. Okay, so the supplier contact number, supplier email, and then tourism tag if let's say is any, supplier SST registration number. If the supplier is an individual supplier, you can just set as NA. Because for the e-invoice, if let's say you got paid to the sales, paid to the agent commission, then you need to also create a supplier because you need to issue self-bill invoice for the commission. Okay. And then industry classification code, then you need to select what is the industry. Okay. If let's say there is no industry, then system will auto detect it as a 0000, not applicable. Okay. So under the supplier address, so you need to update the supplier address here. So if let's say you already create any address, then you can select it, or else you can create directly from here. What is the address name? Is it a home? And then what is your address type? Is it a billing or shipping address? And what is the address information? And then you can set it as a default or set default for the e-invoice address only. Okay. So that's for the e-invoice tab. And then next one is the PayPal. This one, if let's say you are not using direct LHDN, then you need to update under the PayPal configuration. Because when you register with the PayPal, you will have the PayPal ID. Then you need to key in what is the PayPal ID that you already registered. And then system will, then you need to verify. Just do the linkage for the PayPal here. And then next one is the category. So this one, if let's say you got set any category here, then you can just link the supplier to the category. Okay, you just click on the plus and then you will see a list of the category that you already configure. Then you can just, okay. So this one is more on the supplier grouping for your reporting. And then this login, if let's say you have any supplier access, so you can go to the supplier account and put the login ID so that the supplier can only access the applet for that for their information only. Okay. And then payment config is more on the for you to store the payment information of your supplier here. Okay. And then we also have the tax for you to update your tax information of your supplier. And then this address is for you to maintain your address of the supplier. And then the contact also for you to update. If let's say you want to update multiple information of that supplier, then you can just put what is the information of the salesperson, what is the designation, phone number. So it's more on the supplier directory lah for your record. Okay, and then we have the credit term and credit limit. So this one for you to set the what is the credit term and credit limit for this supplier. Okay. And then next one, we have the supplier branch. So this one is used for the intercompany. So if let's say you got intercompany, then you will link that supplier under this tab. So next one, we have the company linking. So this one, because in the ledger, supplier, we are sharing across all the company, across all the company in the tenant. But if let's say you got multiple company and each company have different credit term and credit limit, then you can go to the company linking to link this supplier to what company. So example, if let's say I link this supplier to this company, then when I add, I can go to set what is the credit term and credit limit for this supplier for that company. Okay, so means we able to split it by the company also. Alright, so this is for the company linking, and then we got also the item pricing. So this one, if let's say one of the scenario is you have you are linking the item with the supplier. For example, you got buy one phone, but this phone you are buying from three different suppliers. So you want to set what is the pricing for each of the item for three different suppliers. So you will use this step. Okay, so we put what is the item code, what is the quantity minimum, quantity maximum, consignment, and what is the price. Okay. And then we got the remark. So if let's say you want to key in any remark of the supplier, then you can put the remark here. And then employee. So this employee is more if let's say you want to link this customer to this employee, like a dedicated account manager lah. So you can link the employee to the supplier. Okay, and then last one is the document. So this document is it will show all the history transaction related to this supplier. So if let's say this supplier got any purchase order, then you will see what is the purchase order created under this supplier account, what is the purchase GRN, purchase invoice, and purchase return. All is means we already link all the information of the supplier in this step. Okay. So after you already update all the information of your supplier, then you just click save. Okay. So this is some on the supplier creation. Okay. So if let's say this agency, if let's say you want to export your supplier, then you can right click and then go to export, to export as a CSV or Excel format also can. Okay. So this is so I already briefly explained on the item, on the supplier creation, supplier editing, and also category. Okay, so the next one we go through the file import. So if let's say you want to import in your supplier, then you can go to this function, click on the plus, and then you can see the file, the upload file. So you just export out the upload file, key in all the information, and then upload again to the system. Okay, so as easy as that. So my system will auto create for you the supplier code. All right, so the second last also is the upload function, which is for the credit term and credit limit. Okay, so if let's say you want to do configuration on the applet, so you, if you see here, there is a setting button here. So this setting is more on the applet configuration. So if let's say you have the permission as the admin, so you can go to this to do the configuration. Like you want to hide any tab, then you can just go to hide any tab, and also line setting department. So means this is where you control the applet lah. So if let's say the default selection is where you set the currency, the permission wizard is where you will set the permission of the applet. Okay. Okay, so the personalization here is where you will set the default selection for, if let's say when the user log in, what is the personalization for that user account, what is the branch and location. All right, is there any question from the floor? Got one question here. Is there any limit number of how many category we set for one supplier? Okay, so basically there is no limit, because this one, the category here is more like a label. So means you can label your category, your supplier by a few grouping also can. So means under the category you can put as many category as you want. so that later on we can have a report for you to filter by the selection category. If there is no more question, then we can end our session for today. Thank you.